Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter study of animal tissue. In that we are studying topic type of nerve fibers. Now nerve fibers are basically of two different types depending upon whether they are myelinated or non-myelinated. So let's study about them today. Nerve fibers. Now nerve fibers are very crucial, or simply I say very prominent part of your neuron. There could be only two types of nerve fibers present depending upon whether they are containing myelin sheath or there's an absence of myelin sheath. Also you say nerve fibers as axons, you can say any of those names. So the myelinated, or you say a medullated nerve fiber, and another kind is non-myelinated or non-medullated nerve fiber. So what's the difference between the two? If you talk about the myelinated one, axon in this one is surrounded by Schwann cells, whereas the other one lacks axon. Axon lacks the myelin sheath in it. Schwann cells that are present in non-myelinated cells are present around the periphery region. Also in myelinated sheath, cells secrete a fatty kind of substance insulating the layer of myelin in it, and also they are around or just adjacent to the axon region. Type of nerve fibers. Now nerve fibers could be two different types. One of the type is, you either say it as medullated nerve fiber or myelinated nerve fiber. It simply means that it will have a sheath of myelin in it. Now axon is surrounded by Schwann cells in the myelinated type. Also the cells secrete a fatty kind of layer that's insulating, that provides it protection to the layer of myelin, especially during the impulse of shock reaction or wherever the impulse has to be carried at a faster pace, and this layer is present all around the axons. This sheath is basically interrupted by constrictions or narrowings at regular interval, which is termed as node of Ranvier. Now this node of Ranvier is somewhere related to Schwann cells. Medullated nerve fibers also help to carry nerve impulses, or you say electric impulses or information processing, at a very greater speed as compared to the non-myelinated ones. The next type is the non-myelinated, or you simply say it as non-medullary nerve fibers. Now, being non-myelinated nerve fibers, the axon basically lacks a myelin sheath. And lacking a myelin sheath, the Schwann cells or the periphery of Schwann cells present around the axon never secrete myelin sheath. Now, Schwann cells are the ones that are predetermined to secrete a myelin sheath, but in this, they never try and secrete it. All vertebrates have only non-myelinated nerve fibers present in their body, or you simply say it in the nervous system. In vertebrates, there is the presence of this sheath in the autonomous nervous system. The peripheral nervous system will not have it. It's only the ANS that basically consists of it. Now, depending upon the myelin that's present or whether it is non-myelinated, axons as well as Schwann cells interact timely or depending upon the situation, how the nerve impulse has to be coordinated. Also, depending upon the other type of neurons that are present in the body based on the functions, the amount of myelin sheath that's present in them could vary. It could increase or decrease in certain arthropods or crustaceans. That's in minute quantity. I hope students, we are very clear with this concept of what a myelinated sheath is and what a non-myelinated sheath is. I hope you are aware of it, that a myelinated sheath will consist of and what a non-myelinated sheath will consist of. Thank you.